Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining me once again for another episode of the Tamra Temu Collective, where dreams have no filter. So let's get back into our discussion, our series about moving from religion to spirituality. So what I want to do is I want to present phases. There are phases that a person can go through when you're moving from religion to spirituality. These phases, they're not in order, because sometimes you can experience one phase by itself. Another time, it could be because it's a journey, okay? Because you're reprogramming how you think. Because we already know religion, there's a lot of harming programming that goes on to keep you constantly looking outside of yourself for answers, constantly looking outside of yourself for permission, constantly looking outside of yourself or looking to a leader to do something for you, or constantly looking for a leader because you don't trust your own intuition to take control of your life. We already know that. So you can go through different phases. Now, I'm presenting you phases that I have experienced in my own life. So again, it's not a phase one, phase two, phase three, phase four, phase five. It can be all of those together at different points. Some phases may be more prominent than others. Some phases, you know, it could be, you know, vice versa. Then you have another phase that's more prominent than the last. So you get what I'm saying? All right. So one of the phases that you're going to go through is the excitement. There's an excitement that comes with embracing freedom. Okay. Now, that doesn't mean that the fear isn't lingering on, you know, the fear of, you know, if you leave church, or if you stop reading the Bible for 2 days, or you stop reading whatever text is accompanied with that specific religion, then somehow you're going to be bound. You have the threat of hellfire and brimstone and all that other stuff. You know, there's still an excitement that says, you know what? Yes, I'm embracing my freedom. I know that this religion had me in a closed space, had my mind closed where I could not think for myself, but now I'm free. Okay. So that excitement, it almost feels like, and I hopefully this is a good example for most of you. I hope all of you, but think about the last time you moved from one house to another, or you moved into, you know, a new house, new apartment, or, you know, a new car. We'll say this, a new car. So the car, you know, you stepped into the car, it had that new car smell. We all know that new car smell. Everything was shiny, black on the inside, leather, perfect leather, the smell of the leather. That was exciting because it almost felt like a new adventure with you in this car. Okay. So that's what it can feel like, the excitement. So another example that I'll use is maybe just as simple as getting a new outfit. You know, maybe you bagged up some old clothes that you weren't wearing anymore, and you said, you know what, it's time for me to get rid of these clothes. See, that's a better example. I should have used that first. Okay, so yeah, that's perfect. Moving from religion to spirituality is like going into your closet, looking at clothes that do not appeal to you anymore. Maybe, you know, you have had the same color palette for 10 years, I don't know, 20 years. And you're like, you know what, this palette does not work for me anymore. I'm ready for a new palette. I know I'm not quite sure what that palette is, but I'm just embracing the change because I know that change is going to transform my life in a positive way, because that is the level that I feel called to. That is what I feel called to. So I'm going to bag up these clothes, throw them out. And that, even though you may not know what, like I said, you may not know what the next color palette is. You may not know what specifically maybe spirituality means or what other spiritual practice you want to adopt and start using into your life. It doesn't matter. Just the excitement, just the step to say, this no longer serves me anymore. Going to a church doesn't serve me anymore. The Bible does not serve me anymore. I'm being pulled away from this. I'm being not pulled, but I'm being called to something else. There's the excitement there. Then, and see, here's the thing. Perhaps religion in some aspects, maybe it did serve you. I will say that. So I grew up as a Christian. And so, or I should say, grew up in the Christian religion. And even though it does not serve me anymore, I will say that it sharpened my intuition. What people see on the surface, whether it's through vision or hearing, it has sharpened my ability to hear and see beyond that. And that I am grateful for. That I'm thankful for. So in that sense, it did serve me. So I'm not saying that, you know, this excitement that you have to move from religion, that religion didn't serve you, because perhaps it did at one point. But the motto, the base of this show, is to embrace a higher version now for you. All right. So then, you know, you've got the phase of excitement because you're embracing this freedom that you have. Well, then there's a phase, you know, where you are, you know, you're saying, okay, well, I know that, I understand that I'm a spiritual being. And I know that there's more wisdom to be had. I know that there's more knowledge for me to embrace. And like I said in the first video, maybe there's another religion, perhaps another religion that you may want to study that could be a part of, doesn't mean you have to be a part of another religion, but it could influence your spiritual practice. And a part of that is, okay, well, now I want more knowledge. Now, what's going to happen is all of those questions that you had when you were in that religion, practicing whatever religion that you're moving away from or have moved away from, now all of those questions are going to start to resurface. So now you're in a phase where you're allowing all those questions to come back. You're giving yourself the space and the time, because this is not anything that's rushed. You're giving yourself the space and the time to start asking those questions again. Again, this is not rushed. This is something that you deserve to take your time with. So now you start to ask those questions. And what will happen is that you're going to start to notice that information that you need, the wisdom that you need is going to come to you. It's not going to be something that you're going to have to dig for at all. Okay. Then you got your excitement, your freedom that you're feeling. You know, you've got more knowledge. You're asking more questions. The knowledge is coming to you. Then you start to see synchronicities. Then in the middle of all of that, the doubt, the shame, and the fear is going to try and creep in to sprinkle, you know, to bring a dark cloud over all that you've been feeling, over all the knowledge that you have, because the purpose of doubt, shame, and fear is to pull you back down, is to pull you back into what you're used to. So that's another phase, all right? Then you're going to have, your conversations are going to be different. You know, you'll get, you know, especially if, you know, you've got, if you're around family, perhaps, you know, you have a family that you live with and they start to notice, you know, you have pulled away. So the thing is, the answer, your answer, it does not have to be detailed, whether you're living with family or not. You don't have to explain anything to anyone. Now, if you want to give an answer, here's an answer that you have, like, say, for example, you know, if someone says, hey, I noticed, you know, you're not going to church anymore and, you know, you're kind of, your conversation is different, because people are going to notice. Now, they may or may not come out and ask you what's going on directly anyway. But just in case they do, you can say simply, just say this. Say, I want to make sure I'm growing and evolving as a person. And part of my journey is to study to get more knowledge, to see what I can integrate into my life so that I can continue to transform and expand. That's it. That's all you have to say. Because what that does, when you respond that way, it removes any room for any type of argument. It removes any type of, because really, if you say, if someone asks you a question about, you know, what's going on with you, you know, you're not religious anymore, or however they term the question, that answer, it's hard to rebuttal that. Because we all want to grow as people, right? Or at least that's what we say we want. So then, you know, you've got the phase of the conversations that you may have with family, people closest to you, friends that notice a change. Because it is noticeable, whether you, and you don't have to say anything, but it is going to be noticeable. So, and then this may tie, this next phase, this other phase is going to probably tie into more of the shame, the doubt, and the fear, is the difficulty in embracing this move, this positive change, this transformation that you're having in your life. And it could be after you have gone through the excitement, you've experienced the synchronicities in the information that's coming to you. And let's just say that you do have a spiritual practice in mind that you're already wanting more information about. You do have an idea. Even after all of that, you can still kind of dip back into, okay, is this really what I'm supposed to be doing? You'll still start to question. So this goes back to your vision. Does that tie into the vision that you have for your life? Is it aligned? That's a simple question that you can ask. So what I'm going to do in the next videos is take each of those phases and dedicate each video to those phases. Okay, so let me know so far if you have any questions for me. And thanks again for tuning in to the Tamara Temu Collective, where dreams have no filter. And until next time, cheers.